Hello everybody and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today on the very first Dark Tries of 2024, we're going to be having a look at a very special locomotive. Today, we're going to be having a look at this. This is the Caledonian Railway Drummond Single number 123, brought to Train Simulator by Caledonia Works. So, you might be thinking, hold on a moment, this locomotive has been in game already, hasn't it? Yes, it has, and it was also built by Caledonia Works, because this is his flagship locomotive, his favourite locomotive, the company's favourite locomotive, and one of the starlets of the Caledonian Railway. Therefore, it has been remade from the ground up, from scratch, in 2023 into 2024 by Caledonia Works. So this is a revamped model. Everything about it is new. There's lots of new features which we're going to look at, and we're going to have a look at the liveries included, and we're going to take it for a little spin. And as a little bonus, I think I might do a comparison from old and new. So I've already done a video on this before on the original number 123. I'll try and either put a link in the description or up in the corner or something. But just as a small reminder, what is number 123? So this locomotive was built by Nielsen and Company in 1886 for the Caledonian Railway for the Edinburgh Exhibition, where it won an award. This locomotive then re-entered into traffic with the Caledonian Railway. It is famous for operating on the races to the north in the 1880s, and it was also the Royal Pilot engine for the Royal Train. And this engine ended up working for the Caledonian Railway up until its absorption into the LMS in 1923, where it continued to operate for a little while, but eventually it was withdrawn from traffic and preserved. It did run again in the 1950s and 60s, mainly on rail tour duty, along with a load of other Scottish locomotives. So it was one of the famous locomotives that operated along with some things like, I think it was, at least the one I can remember is the Highland Railway James Goods, number 123. So this engine also operated a couple of famous rail tours, such as the Blue Bell down to the Blue Bell Railway. And it ran a load of other things until it was withdrawn in the 1960s. It was preserved. It's now currently in a museum up in Scotland, in the Riverside Museum. And it's been entombed there and probably will never run again, sadly. However, because of Caledonia Works, we can run it in Train Sim. So that's a brief history of 123. Shall we have a look around at this brand new model and have a look at some of the variations that are included? So this is the 1886 livery. I will orbit the camera around so we can have a look. And you can sort of see that I think Caledonia Works have decided that because this is their famous and sort of like, you know, their favourite engine, they're going to go all out this time. So the livery application is as you'd expect from CW. Texture work is very nice. There's lots of nice little details as well on the locomotive. The crew, for example, have Caledonian Railway caps on, so that's very nice to see. You can also see that the builder's plate is there underneath the splasher. You can see the CR on the tender, the emblem over there on the big splasher, and the number plate, of course. So, I mean, you know, I don't really have to say that much. All I've got to do really is orbit around the locomotive. Just so you can see the amount of detail that CW have put into this one. And I've got to say that even though this is an engine I wouldn't normally really like, because I know that CW really likes it and I know that they put a lot of effort into this one, I am inclined to say that this is probably one of their best products so far in terms of modelling and what you sort of can see on the screen now. I won't say it's the best in value or the best in variations, because there are other packs that have got better value and variation, but because this is a very special locomotive for Caledonia Works, I think it has to have some sort of, you know, some credit given to it, because it is a very, very handsome model. And the fact that it's got all the new features that the old one didn't have, such as Locomotion 2.0, it's got a variation of a couple of headboards, it's got the reporting numbers, I guess you'd call them, or reporting boards on the front of the smoke box you can put on. It's got period accurate lamps, But this is all stuff that you've probably already gathered from what I've been talking about. Just going to scooch in a little bit and we're going to have a look. Because obviously this is still just the first livery. Probably not the most famous of liveries, but it's still a very handsome livery. So what have we got here? So I'll come up here so you can see the Caledonian Railway crest. You can also see the builder's plate just down there, built at Neilson & Company in 1886. You've then got the big Caledonian Railway 123. I was going to say building plate, but it's not. It's a number plate on the side of the cab. And if we come up into the cab, you can see what I meant about the crews. Very high detail crew. And you've also got the Caledonian Railway caps on. I do apologise for the camera work. Long story short, I had a bit of an accident with my hand, so I can't exactly do fluid camera movement very well at the moment. But you've also got the nicely detailed interior to the cab, which obviously should be, because you can see it, you know, quite... What's the word for it? You can see it quite visually because of it being such an open cab. Did notice that the the reverser is basically slamming into the driver's shoulder, but I'm sure that's so we can yank it forward. And obviously the tender is, just as you can see, it's just the standard CR tender. And it's obviously just, I mean, the coal texture's a lot better, I will give it that. New coal texture's nice. I just thought I'd have to say something about the tender as well, because I've talked about the locomotive, we can see the tender, just to do a bit of an orbit round here. Again, this is just me sort of showing off the actual model itself. Again, I'll talk a little bit more about it when I come round to have a look at the comparison sort of bonus bit that I'm going to add to this video. But, you know, I think, you know, credit where it's due. If this is a locomotive that CW have been very passionate about, of course they're going to put their best work into it. So I hope that translates over when I could take a full look drive shortly. But that's enough of this livery. This is sort of like the really balled up livery. You've got the burnishing on the front. You've got the intricate lining and everything. So I think it's time we went over and had a look at some of the other variations that are included. So what I've done is I've stuck them all over there. So let's go have a look. I have put them in some sort of strange order. Bear with me for one moment as we move over here. So what have we got here then? We've got the Caledonian Railway darker blue livery. So in this one, I've put the Royal Train pilot headboard up, which you can do obviously with the scripting in the scenario editor. And I've also put a lamp there on the side of the cab, because obviously with the Caledonian Railway, they didn't put the lamps on the front of the locomotive there. So it has got a very long front end. You've also got the little stars that you can add in the scenario editor. On these three, I've put the stars on. We'll have a look at them as we go around. But this is just the plain silver star. And you can see that the smoke box door opening wheel thing, do you know what, it's not a smoke box dart, but you know what I mean, that's all balled up, that's modelled very well. Modelling is very nice, you know, I don't want to sort of harp on too much about it, but I think because this is a locomotive that he's passionate about, of CW, they've put some of their best work into this, so we'll talk a bit more about that later on. Again, we've got the crest there. We've also got the number on the side, and this time we've obviously got C crest arm on the tender. So, you know, same story really. The modelling's nice, and this is just basically the Caledonian Railway darker blue of the late 1800s, early 1900s. Over here we've got the next livery, which is Caledonian Railway light blue, which is probably the one that most people associate with 123. So this is the sort of like 1900s version of the livery. There's another one next to it, which I think is slightly interesting. We'll look at that in a moment. But you can see this time we've sort of got more of a goldy coloured star behind the smoke box door hinge opening thing. Someone tell me what that actually is. It's just, you know, the wheel that opens the smoke box door. We'll have a look at this side in shadow. You can see that we've got the brake pump here. I don't know whether it's fully animated. Animated. We'll have a look. I'm pretty certain that something on the wheels, on the chassis, is animated. We'll have a look at that when we continue onwards. And again, just I'll orbit around the locomotive just so you can have a look at it in the shadowy parts and in this bit. But yeah, that is the Caledonian Railway light livery, the light CR livery, which I think is really handsome. So next up, we've got an interesting one. So this is when the locomotive was renumbered in 1914. And it ended up being number 1123. I believe that's on the duplicate lists, maybe. Not 100% sure, because as everybody knows, I just play with these things. I do the bare minimum research because I'm evil. But there is actually a full manual included with the pack when you install it, so I would recommend going and reading the manual because it's got quite a lot of information. There's also, this is the third star that's included. It's got these sort of the roundy, I don't know what to call that, like, you know, the loops around the star. Very handsome. It looks really good from a distance, actually. It kind of makes it look very intricate. And the main difference on this livery, as far as I can tell, is obviously the build and plate, not the build and plate, number plate. Obviously reflects that it's now numbered 1123. 3D letters as well, and it's red. And I think this is probably one of the nicer looking liveries, purely because it's nice to have that break up from the blue and the blacks when you've got a little bit of red there on the side of the tender. So that concludes the Caledonian Railway era liveries, not the end of the Caledonian Railway liveries, of course, because we've got another one to look at. But first and foremost, let's have a look at the next one. Now this is London, Midland and Scottish Railway Crimson, which this thing wears really well. And this is when it was numbered 14010. Haven't really mentioned it much yet, but you've seen the lamps as we've been moving around. This one has the LMS style lamps. And I didn't really mention this earlier on, but you've also got these indicators. I think these are route indicators. It's a very nice touch, and I like the little rose on there. That's interesting. So just another little small detail that I thought people might like. Obviously here we've got the number plate on the front. I think it's 3D. Is it 3D? Yeah, it's 3D, which makes a lot of sense considering that this is obviously a single member of the class. So, you know, it would have a nicely applied one of those number plate at the front. So the main difference here is that the building plate has now moved up on the side of the splasher, which, of course, being 7 foot diameter driving wheels, is pretty big. I believe that the sandbox... Yeah, the sandbox is the same on all of them, but it just looks so much bigger on this version. And then obviously here we've got the London, Midland and Scottish Railway crest on the side. And we've now got the number in sort of like the black shaded yellow livery here on the side of the tender. So again, I'll just do another orbit around this one, just so you guys can have a look. I'm not quite sure why I'm making such a big deal over this loco. I think it's just because I know that it's a special locomotive and a lot of effort's gone in. You can also see something interesting, actually, which is the safety valves have moved from the top of the dome back to in front of the cab on the top of the firebox. So I think that is indicative of the rebuild that she had, where she had the safety valve moved. But you can see the difference on the Caledonian ones because the safety valve is up on the dome, and now it's not. So we'll move on to the next livery. So this one is sort of LMS, I wouldn't call it mixed traffic black, but this is sort of how it ended its days on the LMS. Obviously it was always kept in a clean condition because of it being sort of known as the pet of the Caledonian Railway. So I think it was always kept in nice condition, and obviously being a Royal Train pilot, it would be kept in good condition. I do like the line black, and it's obviously retained its number of 14010. And again, you can see the build and play, all the other little grubbins around the locomotive, and the tender lettering now says LMS rather than the number. And yeah, I mean, not much more to say about this LMS livery. It's sort of handsome. It keeps those lines, and I think the lining, if this was in plain black, it would look a little bit less interesting, but because it's lined out, I think it's sort of, you know, it just gives it a bit more pizzazz, I suppose. So obviously this is the end of its working career. With the LMS, it would have been stored and preserved afterwards. So this here is its final livery. And I believe it's the one that it's preserved in, and this is a condition it's preserved in. So this is where it's returned to its original number of number 123. And it now has the regular dome, and the safety valves are obviously still in the position it would have been in when rebuilt. So I think that's kind of interesting, that at least we get to see it in Caledonian livery with the rebuild shape. You've also got the blue bell headboard included and a few other things. Haven't shown them all, but there are other headboards that you can include. And again, I mean, we've seen this livery, but now you can see it with the modified dome. And yeah, it's a very handsome looking livery. And I think this is the one that most people know number 123 to look like. It's obviously a little bit brighter, I think, than the original Caledonian Railway livery. And as you can see on the side of the tender here, at the very least, because this is the 1960s livery, and because it worked over the West Coast Main Line and up in Scotland, it would have worked underneath the live wires. Therefore, it ended up getting the live wire stickers. Well, they're plates, aren't they, really? Not stickers, but, you know, it received those in this condition. I believe there was one near the front somewhere. Maybe I missed it. Perhaps I have missed it, but it does have the live wire stickers at the very least, or plates if you want to call them that. So that's 7 liveries in total. So you get 7 liveries. This is all of the working day liveries that you include with it. And you've also got obviously that one over there for the little show around at the front. But that's not all you get in the pack, as you've probably already noticed. Caledonia Works has also remodeled the coaches, the Caledonian Railway coaches that came with it. Now, the only thing I find interesting is there's no brake coach as far as I can tell. There's a third and a composite in various liveries. So we'll have a look around at those. Oh, excuse me, sorry. We'll have a look around at those. So obviously this is the Caledonian Railway livery. And you've got Caledonian Railway here on the front on the corridor connection. And, you know, pretty good modelling, I must say. I think it's CW that's done this. It could have been one of his other team members that did this. But, you know, you can sort of see that it's quite a handsome looking coach. And if we come back here, you can see the other one. I mean, you only get 2 coaches with both liveries, but still, it's nice to see them included. It means that you can do plenty of little quick drives, which this thing has. So, that's a good bonus. I'm just going to sort of scooch back around to the front. I think the modelling on the interior has also done pretty well as well. Got some people in there. Some nice actual people in here. Very nice. We're going to have a look around a little bit more, actually. So, what have we got here? Yeah, do you know what? Interior of the coach. Don't think I can fault this. Maybe. Maybe we should see some more coaching packs. I mean, I know we've got more coaches now coming from CW, from Gordon Mack, aka Matrix Trains. So, I don't know. It'd be fun if this was actually his. I don't think it is, but it would be fun. But yeah, some nice interior liveries. Interior details, anyway. Points have to go for the modelling of inside of the coach. I believe if we come through the corridor here. Yeah, we've got another one here. This is the third class coach. And you've got some interesting little tidbits in here as well. So, credit where it's due. The modelling of the coach that you include with this actually is pretty good. I think that's quite solid. Wonder how it would be on the move. So, just very quickly, we've got the LMS Period 1 livery as well included here. I'm not going to go all the way down the coach, but you can basically see from here that it's the LMS Period 1. Next to it, we've got the Period 3, so the Stanio era. So it's sort of like the darker crimson, if you like, or, well, the lighter-ish crimson, I suppose. And then finally, we've got this, which is the Caledonian Railway livery again, as it would have appeared in the 1960s behind 123, with the warning stickers, of course, or plates, if you want to call them that. So there you have it. That is everything that is included with this pack. There is a link in the description if you do want to pick it up. It's currently $19.99. So that's all the liveries that are included in the pack. You also get the coaches, you get the 7 liveries, you get the rebuilt version. So now we're going to do a bonus piece where we're going to have a look at the new model compared to the old Caledonia Works model. So I will see you all in a moment. So, before we go and have a drive of the new Caledonian Railway 123, I thought it would be nice to insert this bonus section where we have a look at the old model compared to the new model. So, the original Caledonian Railway 123 was released all the way back in December 2017 on Digital Traction, built by Chris Wilson of Caledonia Works. So this was his first payware locomotive released. And obviously, that is on the left here. And on the right is the newest one that has just been released here in 2024. So what we're going to do is we're going to compare and contrast. We're going to have a look around at the old model and the new one and see if we can spot any differences and see how it's evolved. So the first thing that's probably evident is the textures. So if we just scooch in a little bit here, just so we can see both of them, you can see that the new 123 is a much brighter shade of blue compared to the older one, which is a much darker shade of blue. Now, this could vary depending on your system. I use Railworks Enhancer to enhance the lighting and whatnot, so the results could be different. But you can see mostly that the old one is a bit darker than the new one. So features are pretty similar. They do use the same sound set, which is unavoidable. But you can see that some of the options are still there. You can see that it still has the Royal Train Pilot headboard, but the new one does have more. You can also see that it's got the stars as well. I believe there's the same amount of options for those. And the major difference I can actually see from this vantage point, which I'm going to scooch around to show you all, because bear in mind that this one that we're looking at here is 6 years old, and it was his first model locomotive in Train Sim, is the tender textures on the coal and on the tender texture itself. So if I sort of pull back and scooch up, because I'm using my Xbox controller, and then scooch forward again, we can have a look at the difference in the textures on the tender. So obviously the one at the rear is the new, one at the front is the old, and you can see that the tender texture has indeed changed and is a completely 3D model now, whereas in the old days it wasn't. You can also see that the textures on the locomotive and cab side and over on the locomotive, they're a lot less shiny back in 2017. You can also see that the textures on the number plate are different, a lot darker. But you know what? Overall, considering this was his very first model, I think it still holds up, even compared to the new one. Unfortunately, this one isn't available anymore. The old one has been discontinued. It was made free for a little while, a long time ago. So most people who wanted it will probably have it. So yeah, I'm looking at this, and yeah, you can still see some of the sort of pixelated bleeding of textures on the old locomotive. Compared to the new one, it is quite obvious, but the bump map is still pretty good. You've also got, still had a 3D crew back then. This one is obviously slightly less detailed than the new ones, but I think they've got a charm all of their own. You can sort of see as well that it has got the Caledonian Railway caps on as well. I like the detail of the little pipe. I think that was supposed to actually be modelled on Mr. Wilson himself, actually, purely because of the mustache. You can see that the cab is still relatively good and detailed. I think there are some bits that are obviously better on the new one. If we scooch over now, yeah, you can really see how much more detail there is in this cab. You look at this cab for a moment, so you can see that you've got, like, you know, the texture work is so much better and the modelling is so much better there compared to the older one, where it sort of looks a little bit more blocky. The textures don't really pop as much. So just by comparing the cabs from the same angle, you can see how much CW have improved over the years. So, you know, and again, that coal texture is just night and day, particularly, I find. So as regards to the locomotive and the modelling, I mean, yeah, if we just sort of come around here, you can definitely see that there was a big difference in the modelling. You know, it pops a lot more, the new one does, compared to the old one. But I still think the old one holds up, and for its time, it was a good model. But now we've got the new one to supersede it, and there's a lot more features and functionality. So, which we're going to actually have a look at. At least one thing I've noticed is that the brake block rigging is animated on the new one. I'm not sure whether it was on the old one, but that's still a nice feature to have. Also, the new one, of course, does have things that weren't available to CW back then, such as auto fireman through the scripting. You've also got the performance mode as well, which was on the original one, but is obviously a lot better now. And you've also got the simple and advanced mode on the new 123. Now, something that I do want to point out that I find interesting, though, in comparison, if we're comparing, I have just said that the textures are a bit dated on the old one, and I do think it still holds up. But something I found interesting is in the coaches that come with this pack. So with the new one, you get two. With the old one, you actually do get a full brake coach. Now, they're not as sort of intricately modelled as the original and the new one, sorry. But the fact you got three is kind of an interesting bump to sort of give the old one some points. And the textures on the coaches are pretty similar. You can see that they were still modelled with love and care and affection, but obviously the texture is now less muddy in modern times, especially on the text. The interiors are still there, well, or lack thereof in the brake, but you can see that there is still, you know, a little bit to be desired inside here compared to the new one that we looked around a while ago. I mean, the passenger models are definitely dated, especially this guy. But I mean, they're still not too bad, to be honest. But obviously the new one, does have just, you know, it does have a nicer interior. I believe it's also got a nice passenger view. We'll have a look at that in a little while. But for all intents and purposes, this has been your bonus section of us having a look at the old versus the new. You can obviously clearly see as well that the particle effects are different and they're less intensive on the new one, which is on the left, old one on the right. And I think just in general, there's a higher fidelity with the new one. So what would I say to this? I would say that Caledonia Works has definitely gotten better over the years, and it's really nice to be able to do one of these compare and contrast. If more locomotives come out that are of the same sort of vintage and have this kind of, you know, connection to them, or are basically the same model but many, many years later, I may well consider doing some more compare and contrasts in future. But for now, that's what you get, basically. That's my little comparison of them. Would I have recommended the old one today? Probably, if it was freeware. If the old one was now freeware again, but on a permanent scale, because it has become freeware a couple of times in the past. If it was still available, I would say if you want to drive something that is CW, yes, but you're better off buying the new one because there is much more fidelity to it. So my recommendation is, if you like the Caledonia 123, then by all means purchase the new one. It's a worthy replacement. But I don't find anything particularly wrong with the old one, which says a lot about the quality overall, which is that I think that overall the quality has jumped over the last 6 years, and, you know, basically well done for, you know, coming up to this stage where you can actually remake an old DLC and make it much better. So that's sort of the modelling and everything looked at. That's my little compare and contrast. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and set up the new Caledonia 123, and we're going to take it for a little run somewhere. So in a moment we shall do that. I will see in a second. So here we are with Caledonian Railway, Drummond single number 123. We have three coaches sat here at Betuck Station, ready to tackle Betuck Incline on the West Coast Main Line. But before we have a montage of that, what we're going to do is we're going to go into the cab, we're going to have a look around in there, I'm going to show off some of the features, we're going to cycle through the camera views, and as a bonus, we're also going to cycle through the camera views that are included with the coaches. So, without further ado, here is the cab of Caledonia Railway number 123. So this is competently modelled by Caledonia Works again, so it's all very nice in here, as we discussed earlier. You know, the textures are nice, everything is pretty much where it should be. I even noticed a nice touch, which is that you've got BR up there on one of the gauges, because obviously this is the sort of BR era rail tour version, even though it's painted Caledonian livery. I like that. That's a nice little feature. So what else have we got here? Controls-wise, we've got the brakes here, so we can release them or we can put them on. I'm leaving them on for the time being because we're sat at the station. You've got the reverser in front of us here, which is of course a lever reverser. It has a reverser lock, which you can control with E in advanced mode. More about that in a minute. You've also got the firebox down there, of course. So we're going to leave that open for a moment. We've also got the regulator in front of us, the big regulator handle there. All the various gauges, water gauges and whatnot. Over there, we've got a little Easter egg, which is a Bible and a smoking pipe. So anybody who knows Mr. Wilson will know all about that. So that's what you get inside the cab. Those are the controls. What we'll do now is we'll have a cycle through of the camera views. They're the regular Caledonia Works cameras. So you've got the driver's side here. You've got the firebox there, fireman's side, out of the cab, down here by the driving wheel. This one, which I find handy to look down at the valve gear there if you move the camera back. You've got down here at the front, up here in front of the loco, and then it's basically the same but mirrored on this side. So you kind of get the drill. You get the drill there. So that is everything that is included there with the camera views. So what other features are there? Well, let's have a look at some of the ones that are more useful for driving. So first and foremost, we have simple mode and advanced mode, which is controlled with control A. So at the moment I'm in advanced mode, so I'd have to use the reverser lock to move the reverser. Just as an example, you do control A, you'll get the pop-up to say simple mode's on, and now you don't need to worry about the reverser lock, so you can move it to your heart's content. Next up, we've got the auto fireman. So if I now close the firebox for a moment and then do Control R, the fireman will now start doing that. He'll top up our water. He'll keep on top of the fire. And it means you can concentrate on driving. So that's one of the features that you get. Another one, of course, is the standard Shift P for performance mode. So you can turn it on to either low, which turns off the shadows, or you can put it to maximum, which I'm going to leave it at to get rid of the point lights. And that just helps with performance on your computer. So now that we've said all that, what else is there to talk about? Well, two little things before we start looking at the camera views inside the coaches. It's nice to see the return of two little features I've noticed. So first and foremost, and I imagine this is because it's number 123, so it's a pet engine of Caledonia Works. You've got an animated brake pump in there, which is nice to see again. And if we come down here to the wheels, we can see, along with all the springing and modelling that's been done in there, you've actually got animated brake blocks now. So if I now release the brakes, which I need to do anyway, you should see, once the brake pipe starts going off, there you go, you can see that it moves. It's not very well lit, but I think you saw that. So just as another example, if I now put them back to brakes on, you should be able to see them move again, and then into release again, they should come off, which is what we actually need them to be anyway, so that's fine. So just wanted to point out those two nice little things. And next up, we're going to have a look inside the coach views. But as for the locomotive, that's everything that I can think of. We have also got sound to talk about. So, and we have got the older style whistles that came with the original 123, but I don't find anything particularly wrong with them, so I'm not too worried about that. The particle effects, as I mentioned earlier, are all brand new. You know, the ones that CW are now using compared to the old one. So overall, we're going to have a look at the coaches and they'll give you my sort of overall score. But overall, the locomotive is absolutely fine. So as for the final bonus, we're going to have a look at the camera views that come with the coaches. So in typical fashion for rail tour window hanging, you've got these sort of camera views here, looking forward. You've also got this one here inside the coach, which is nice. And then you've got views looking back the other way. So you can actually sort of just window hang, or you can just sit inside and enjoy the view. Now, if I go back to coaches, we should now get another few camera views here and we should get a different interior. There we go. So there you go. Overall, then, if I just come out and then go back up to the top, we should be able to give ourselves a DDJP review score. So I think, all things considered, and considering that this is a rework of an old model and it's now been brought up to modern standards, I would give this a ham and cheese sandwich out of a ham and cheese toastie. I repeat, that is a ham and cheese sandwich out of a ham and cheese toastie, which is a very, very high score in my books. So I would like to say thank you to Caledonia Works for letting me review this product or view it or whatever, like, you know, look at it. You can purchase this from Caledonia Works for $19.99. I have put a link in the description. And all there is now to say is that if you'd like to get the Caledonian Railway 123, would I recommend it? Yes, if you like the Caledonian Railway 123. It's also very handy if you'd like some new coaches. So bear that in mind if you would like to get this for Train Simulator. So now I'm going to stop talking completely. We're going to now have a montage of me climbing BTUC so you can hear the sounds of the 123 and have a look at it in action. So if you'd like to jump off here, thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate that some people just watch the review part, but I'd like to do the little montage just for those people who want to see the locomotive in action. So thank you everyone for watching, and let's now see the locomotive in action. And I will see you all and talk to you all in the next video, which may well be a Twitch live stream, also linked in the description. So let's see what this thing can do. Thank you. Let's go.